shoes, the giraffe. I didn't see you there.
Well, I was just around the corner, checking you out, Minnie.
Oh, Shields, you're such a romantic.
And in French, what is this? You spent time in Paris?
Oh, oui. I spent time in South France and in Paris, and that's where I became a huge fan.
Gypsies. First of all, check that out. Is that beautiful or what? The pictures in this book, I took a peek. They're kind of beautiful. Here we go.
In an old house in Paris that was covered with vines, lived 12 little girls in two straight lines. In two straight lines, they broke their bread and brushed their teeth and went to bed. They left the house at 9:30. The smallest one was Madeline. In another old house that stood next door lived the son of the Spanish ambassador. He was all alone. His parents were away. He had no one with whom to play. He asked, "Please come. I invite you all to a wonderful gypsy carnival." Dear reader, here we go. Up and down up, they hoped the wheel would never stop. Round and round, children cried, "Dear Miss Clavel, just one more ride." A sudden gust of wind, a bolt of lightning, even the rooster found it frightening. The big wheel stops, the passengers land. How fortunate there is a taxi stand. I guess they're a good getaway from a stormy day. "Hurry, children, off with these things. You'll eat in bed. Mrs. Murphy brings the soup of the evening. It is 9:30. Good heavens! Where is Madeline?" Poor Miss Clavel. How would she feel if she knew that on top of the Ferris wheel, in weather that turned from bad to rotten, Pepito and Madeline had been forgotten? Pepito said, "Don't be afraid. I will climb down and get some aid." It was downpouring more and more as he knocked on the gypsy's caravan door. The gypsy mama with her umbrella went and got some help in a circus tent. With the aid of the strong man and the cloud, Madeline was safely taken down. The gypsy mama tucked them in and gave them potent medicine. The big wheel was folded and the tent. They packed their wagons and away they went. For gypsies do not like to stay. They only come to go away. That's why they're called gypsies. A bright new day. The sky is blue. The storm is gone. The world is new. This is the castle of Fountain Blue. All this, dear children, belongs to you. How wonderful to float in a pool. Watch other children go to school. Never have to brush your teeth and never, never go to sleep. The gypsies taught them grace and speed and how to ride the circus steed. That'll come in handy for a circus career. Then Madeline said, "It's about time we sent dear Miss Clavel a line." Poor Miss Clavel, a shadow of her former self, from worry because instead of 12, there were only 11 little girls, stopped brushing their curls and suddenly revived when the postal card arrived. "Thank heaven," she said, "the children are well. But dear, oh dear, they've forgotten how to spell." She slayed the postcard, the postman, and then fast and faster, she rushed to the scene of the disaster. The gypsy mama didn't like at all what she saw in her magic crystal ball. The gypsy mama said, "How would you like to try on this lovely costume of a lion?" With curved needle and some string, she sewed both the children in. And nobody knew what was inside that tough old lion's leathery hide. A circus lion earns his bread by scaring people half to death. You know,
After doing that, he's fed. And after that, he's put to bed. A lovely dawn and all was well. The lion roamed through wood and dell. He smelled sweet flowers. He came to a farm. He frightened the barnyard, intending no harm. Saw a man and said, "Please help! Help us to get out of this old pelt!" The man was a hunter. He took his gun, he got to his feet, and started to run. Thank goodness he didn't shoot them. Said the lion, "We'd better go back, for if we're not in a zoo or a circus, we'll surely be shot." They got to the tent in time for the show. "Look," said Madeline, "there, in the front row!" "Oh, yes," said Pepito. "There are people we know." "Dear Miss Flavel, at last we found you. Please let us put our arms around you." The gypsy mama sobbed her grief into her only handkerchief. The strong man suddenly felt weak, and tears were running down his cheek. Even the poor clown had to cry as the time came to say goodbye. Best part of a voyage by plane, by ship, or train is when the trip is over and you are home again. Aww. Here is a freshly laundered shirty. It's better to be clean than dirty. In two straight lines, they broke their bread and brushed their teeth and went to bed. Good night, little girls. Thank the Lord you are well. And now please go to sleep, said Miss Clavel. And she turned out the light and closed the door. And she came back just to count them once more. And that was a beautifully drawn and rhymerific story of Madeline and the Gypsies.
Huh, that took me back to the old days.
A lion belt?
Why, yes, I was.
Oh, is it? All right, kid, hope you enjoyed Madeline and the Gypsies, and see you next time on It Is Youth.